Hello everyone, in this video I'm gonna show you how to use your fingers to do 9 times table. Very magical actually. And not only I will show you some one digit by one digit examples, I will also show you some two digit by one digit examples. Okay. Alright, let's start. So first of all, you put your hands out like this, and then let me use 2 times 9 as an example. So 2 times 9 is 18. What you do is you start counting your fingers from the left. 1, 2. And then you put down your second finger. Some of you probably already see the answer, right? So how many fingers to the left? Just 1. How many fingers to the right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So your answer is 18. Did you see it? Alright, let's do another example. 3 times 9. So you start counting your fingers from the left. 1, 2, 3. So you put down the third finger. How many fingers to the left? 1, 2. How many fingers to the right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So the answer is 27. All right. 4 times 9. 1, 2, 3, 4. So you put down the fourth finger. How many fingers to the left? 3. How many fingers to the right? 5 plus 1, 6. Right? So you answer 36. And 5 times 9 is 45. 4 to the left, 5 to the right. 6 times 9, 5 to the left, 4 to the right. 7 times 9, 6 to the left, 3 to the right. 8 times 9, 7 to the left, 2 to the right. 9 times 9, 8 to the left, 1 to the right. Now, how about 10 times 9? 10 times 9, you put down the 10th finger, right? So this is called multiplicand. It tells you which finger to put down. So 10th finger, you put down 10th finger. And to the left, you have 9 fingers. So that's 9 here. And to the right, you have 0. So that's 0 here. All right, let's get back to the first multiplication. We haven't forgot about that. 1 times 9. So you put down the first finger. How many fingers to the left? None. So you don't have numbers. How many fingers to the right? You have 9. Pretty cool, right? And in this video, I'm gonna just show you how to do it. And I'll make another video on why you can do it this way. Okay, there's actually math behind all of this that explains why you can do math with fingers. All right, so let's do some more tricky ones. In fact, for those double digit times single digit, we need to have additional rules. Okay, so it builds on those rules, but we need to add something. 14 times 9. Again, you put your hand out like this, 14. This one digit in your multiplicand always decide which finger you put down. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So you put down the fourth finger. And now you have 6 fingers to the right. That always becomes your one digit. Okay. So your answer is going to be a 3-digit number. So your one digit is always the fingers to the right of the finger you put down. So 6, right? 6. Now you have to decide what is your ones digit and hundreds digit in your answer. Okay. So apparently it cannot be 36 anymore, right? Because otherwise it's going to be the same as 4 times 9. So how do we figure out the ones digit, the tens digit and hundreds digit from those three fingers? In fact, one of them is going to become your hundreds digit. And that's the finger right here. And why? Because the tens digit in your multiplicand actually will become your hundredth digit here. And that's the finger right here that you're gonna use to represent your hundredth digit. And then you have two fingers left between the hundredth finger and the finger you put down. So those two fingers is gonna become your 10th digit. So the answer is 126. And again, in this video, I'm gonna show you how, but I'm not gonna talk about why. That's gonna be in another video, okay? So basically this is how it works. This number tells you which finger to put down. So to the right, that's your 1th digit. And your 100th digit is decided by this 10th digit in your multiplicand. So that's the finger right here. And you can put it down if you want, okay? And then you have two fingers left, that becomes your 10th digit. Let's do another example. 36 times 9. 36 times 9, think about it, which finger you should put down? 6, right? So 6th finger you put down. And to the right, you have 4 fingers left. That means your 1th digit is 4. All right? And then you have 5 fingers left to the left. 3 of them is going to be your 100th digit. 3 of them, 1, 2, 3, is going to be your 100th digit. And the 2 here is going to be your 10th digit. Okay. So you put the 4th finger down. Those are your 1th digit. And the 5 here, 3 of them will become your 100th digit. And 2 of them will become your 10th digit. Okay. So you basically, your 100th and 10th digit split the number of fingers left to the left of the finger you put down. Okay. Another example. 57 times 9. 57 times 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I put down this finger. So I know my 1th digit is 3. Okay. Now I decide my 10th and 100th digit. 100th digit is 5. So those 5 fingers will become your 100th digit. How many fingers you have left between 100th digit and the finger you put down? Just 1. So the answer would be 5, 1, 3. 513. You can double check with your calculator or do it in your head using other method if you want. Okay. Another example. 68 times 9. You put down the 8th finger, which is 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, right? 2 will become your 1th digit. 6 is gonna become your 100th digit, right? So 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And you have only 1 finger left to become your 10th digit. Okay, did you see that? To the right, 1th digit, to the left, you have 6 fingers represent 100th, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then you have this 1 left for your 10th digit. So your answer is going to be 612. 612. Let's do one last example. 89 times 9 seems a really big number, right? But we can handle it. 9, put down the 9th finger. This is the 9th finger, you put that down. And then you have 1 left to the right. 1 left to the right. That becomes your 1th digit. So, to the left, you have 8 fingers. But your 100th digit need to have 8 fingers. So that means there's nothing left for you 10th digit. So this 8 fingers all becomes your 100th digit. And nothing left for your 10th digit, so that becomes 0. And 1 left to the right becomes your 1th digit. Okay, so one more time, put down the 9th finger. This is your 1th digit here. And this becomes your 100th digit. So your 8 fingers here become your 100th digit. Nothing between 100th digit and the finger you put down. So this means your 10th digit is going to be 0. Okay. All right. So that's it. Hopefully you guys can enjoy the video. And I also want to leave some questions for you to think about. If you noticed, all of the examples here I have, in the multiplicand, you can see the 1th digit is always greater than the 10th digit, right? 7 greater than 5, 8 greater than 6, 4 greater than 1. And then you can use a rule I just taught you to do all of those, no problem. Okay, but if you have questions like this, it's gonna be a little bit different, because those ones, if you noticed, in the multiplicand, the 10th digit is actually greater than the 1th digit, and this will involve your borrowing digits or borrowing fingers, and then you have to have another rule to do that. Okay, so I'll make a video about it, but at the same time you can think about it, how do you use fingers to do those multiplications. But either way, you can literally use your fingers to do 9 times table up to at least 100, so from 1 to 99, all using just your fingers. And again, I'm gonna make a video showing you why. So I know some of you will say, we can do this with a calculator or a times table, true, no problem. But the point of this video is to show you that math is not something that's invented by humans, that's separate from life. Math actually comes from life, and you see it everywhere, you're experiencing it on a daily basis, and hopefully we can all appreciate the magical power of math. And someone may even say math is the language of the universe, and the more you learn about it, the more you will may realize it may be the truth. Thank you.